Welcome out, everyone. All of you great decoders around the world, wherever you may be, both male and female. My name is Logan, and this, of course, is Decode Your Reality, and this is going to be another decoding short. I know a lot of you have been asking for me to do more of these. I wanted to get some content out to all of you, especially on this special event that just happened on the funny part on 420, which, you know, maybe you smoked a bowl when you watched it, if you did, the official cannabis day, but it was the eclipse of the sun by the moon on 420, the eclipse of 2023. And this one, you know, I wanted to break down the astrological pieces to this for those of you that are interested on how to get more involved with astrology, and going to bring in some decoding efforts on this one as well to show you the scripted reality that we live in during these times. It's just so funny, but let's jump into this one, ladies and gentlemen. The eclipse 2023. Let's start off with some numerology, the science of numbers. And this is what happens during this event, or these events. The moon blocks the sun and you have a solar eclipse. This is why, like, there are a lot of people, and I have kicked this idea around myself a lot, viewing the moon, people saying the moon's not real. Well, if you are someone who thinks the moon's not real, how does this event happen? Because something's blocking the sun during these eclipses. So it kind of like really puts a big butcher knife in that whole theory. Okay, I've gone through a lot of astronomy, amateur astronomy videos, filming the moon, putting a telescope to the moon, and whether it was created by entities other than the GOD, that's besides the point. And there's no one to be able to prove that, but it gets a little ridiculous when people say it's just a reflection off the firmament. And well, then what's blocking the sun on a solar eclipse? I would really ask you to really use some critical thinking on that. Okay. So a solar eclipse is, through numerology, is a 44. Interesting that solar is 16. The word light is 16. Matching that, I mean, this is, we're blocking the light, the eclipse. Okay, and we're gonna now show the tarot, how beautiful the tarot cards are in describing this reality. And this is how I feel and support that we live in a scripted reality. Mankind just is along for the ride. This is another perfect example of that. This is the Eight of Cups, the 44th card in the deck. And what do you notice on the card right away that's a dead giveaway that kind of matches up with a solar eclipse? That's right. It's right there on the card. And so, you know, like a lot of words equal the number 44 in Chaldean numerology, forgetting about going outside the spectrum of Chaldean numerology. So, you know, you can't get every word right with every card, obviously, but how many times have I been showing this? A lot of you great decoders have been showing how these words in numerology connect to the tarot, and they show the picture, and it's just, I mean, You would, as an author drawing these cards out, you can't sit down with all the words in the vocabulary of the dictionary and get them all close like this to get the picture to match the actual word or words that are coming out here. This is why I support us living in a scripted reality. But let's keep going with this this eclipse 2023. Now we're going to bring in some alchemy, the next layer to this. And there's not really much here. You know, this is the 44th element, ruthenium. It does have an average weight of 101. That is the 26th prime number. You add that up, 101 and 26, you get 127, which is tied to the Earth, okay? Which has something to say there because we need to observe the eclipse. But the 101 being tied to the 26, and of course our blood and all that stuff. But what's really fascinating about this, and what led me to really the drum roll for this piece of this decode, is the name comes from the Latin name for Russia called Ruthenia. But that wasn't the big takeaway and probably the big, big drop here for this decode. It was bringing Russian into this. Because a lot of people ask me as well, like, oh, you're just decoding the English language. Okay, well, let's use and decode the Russian language. So here it is. Here is the word for Russia, where this element came from. Now, here it is right here. I just typed it into Google, the conversion of English into Russian. There it is. copied and pasted it, dropped it into the numerology cipher, and there it was, 25. Which is so interesting, ladies and gentlemen, because it's a match to the words, Black Sun. And what are we looking at here? Black Sun. So what is the Black Sun? Well, I have a decode coming out on Prison Planet 4. This material that I have coming out will be the most up-to-date material that I have come out with thus far, obviously, but it's going to really, really put into perspective of what it means to live in a prison planet. And it's not doom and gloom. It's not what it means, but I'm really leaning now towards the moon being the Black Sun. And the yin yang in the sky is the white sun, and the Black Sun is the moon. And you know, it's tied to Xenos and Xenon, the stranger in your head. I really am leaning towards the moon being the server in the sky, if you will, and it kind of running your thoughts. Can you break free from that? Well, that's besides the point, but is it possible? Maybe, maybe not. I mean, I'm still trying to figure it out and I'm heavily involved in this. But I thought this was just absolutely mind-blowing right here. A dead giveaway, how beautiful this code is, using a language that's not even our own in the English. So those of you that are watching from Russia, rejoice, because you have this nice bridge here, this key going right back to the English, the Black Sun. So now it's pretty crystal clear. The moon is the Black Sun, if you ask me. I'm going to tell you that the moon is the Black Sun. So now let's get into some astronomy and astrology to finish off this decoding show on the eclipse for 2023. And here is the eclipse. Now, I measured it in Australia. That's where I got the astrological map from, a location in Australia, 22 degrees north latitude, okay? But what I wanted to point out, because I get a lot of people now that are coming to my research, and I'm a fan of both tropical and sidereal astrology, but sidereal Vedic astrology is the only astrology that matches up exactly with astronomy. Not tropical. That doesn't mean tropical doesn't have its say in our reality. That's how magic works. But what you're looking at right here is the eclipse. Okay, this is around the timestamp of the eclipse, around 11:30 a.m. And the sun and the moon are right there. And they're right past the sign of Pisces. They're in Aries. Okay, 5 degrees. Here's the nighttime look of it. Moved a little bit forward so you can get a little bit of a better rendition of it. So it's out of Pisces. Okay, and it's moving, and it can now consider the realm of Aries, the real estate of Aries. And then you have Mercury in Aries. Saturn, you can clearly see, ladies and gentlemen, Saturn is in Aquarius. It is nowhere near Pisces. So when you hear someone say, Saturn's in Pisces, well, not according to the astronomy map of the sky, it's not. Jupiter is in Pisces. Okay, but if you go to tropical astrology, it's going to tell you a different story. I am all about trying to really synchronize these things. 1 + 1 = 2. Trying to get it as close as we can to synchronize all these layers. So there it is during the daytime. There it is during the nighttime, the eclipse. And the moon's right on top of the sun, obviously, which tells us the moon has to be real. There has to be some realness to the moon there, ladies and gentlemen. Artificial construct or not, that's debatable anyway. But let's finish this thing up with the astrological maps. I'm going to be using both Western and sidereal Vedic astrology to show you the variations in case you're a fan of both. I'm a fan of both systems, but I favor the sidereal Vedic because it's the true map of the stars. And what you're seeing right here is a big cluster of energy. This chart, actually, if I go and show you right here, it was I did it from Exmouth in Australia, okay? 22 degrees, or 21 degrees latitude south. I should have said, why don't I say north? 21 degrees latitude south. I think I said 22, but 21 degrees latitude south in Exmouth, Australia. Okay, and then we have the tropical right here, okay? And the variations are very crystal clear. The big cluster of energy here is the sun on top of the moon. They're at 5 degrees. So here it is. You're looking at it right there. The sun and moon are at 5 degrees, both of them, okay? And you also have, of course, the nodes of the moon, the north and south nodes of the moon there. And these are all in the first nakshatra called Ashwini. And I'm gonna be talking about that and the relevance of that. Like, what kind of energy is being delivered? What can you do? What can you do to use this energy to have a better experience in this reality? And why I have Mars here is because, of course, Mars is the ruler of Aries. So instantly and automatically, we have a large surge of Mars energy coming into the planet. And I had just released a post on my social media page and my Telegram group and my channel here on YouTube in the community that Mars was in the sixth nakshatra of Ardra, and how perhaps there could be some people that are in your life that are really trying to push your buttons. They're really trying to start fights and debates. You may be getting into arguments with people. I had a lot of comments, people saying, yeah, for some reason my anger's up, my toleration level's down. I had people, for the past couple weeks, I've had people coming at me just out of the clear blue, and I'm just like a hermit at home doing my work, and people just coming at me out of the clear blue for no odd reason. Well, I say it's because of this energy of Mars in Ardra. Ardra is the god of the destruction. This is, Rahu was here during the Twin Tower collapse, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, the Twin Towers representing Gemini. But if you wanna have arguments really come to heighten states, this is the time that it's gonna be happening. And if you've been wondering why people are a little crazy, well, you know, Mars is right at the tail end of that as well. So it's ready to move out of there, which will be good news for people. The people start to calm down, hopefully a little bit. Mars's energy, but nonetheless, because of, somebody asked me, like, does it affect the lunar solar eclipse affect Mars? Yeah, of course, because Mars is the ruler of Aries, and Mars is over here. So we just jump around, and they're all playing in unison together. These placements, these celestials, even Saturn, even Pluto. You know, they all work as a unit. But the big cluster of energy here being in the first sign of Aries, it's in the 11th house of Aquarius. Seemingly we're moving into or have moved into the age of Aquarius. And, you know, another big one was Uranus. That's why I got a picture of Uranus here, because Uranus is kind of the ruler of Aquarius, I think. You know, the old school is going to be Saturn, but as soon as Uranus came in 1871, it became the co-ruler, and it fits Aquarius a little more. Now, this is Aquarius's natural house, its domicile house, but Aries is there, so it's going to be an Aries-Aquarius energy. And so, and when Uranus is here in its own house, it's like happy home. And this is all about, I feel, technology, the ushering in of technology, the energy coming in for the Uranus energy to use through technology. And the eclipse here is having a big say into this. Now, moving forward on here, with the Ashwini and the nakshatra, I'm going to get over to the tropical here in a second. Here are the favorable aspects for this solar eclipse 2023. Beginning new things, because it's the magician. The first nakshatra, the first zodiac sign, it's the first card when you synchronize this together. It's the magician. So it's time now, ladies and gentlemen. It's not going to last forever. If you want to start something new, this is the time to do it, man. Lay your seeds, start your foundations, open up your business, file your name for your business, propose to your loved one. This is a time for all these favorable activities right here. Focusing on healing yourself, self and physical improvements. All of these are to take opportunities for in our reality, for all of us at this point. That's what using astrology for the benefit of your life is all about. And then the picture, you being the magician. And you know, this is the house of friends. So it could be a time for you to get out there and mingle, ladies and gentlemen. This could be a time, if you're single and you're looking to meet somebody, this could be a time for you to get out there and go mingle. Or if you're looking to create some new friends, or you're looking to hire some new people, start off with friendships. This is a time to start new things. It's getting out there and mingling, because this is the house owned by Aquarius. the 11th house. Now, if I go back up over here and we look at the tropical, again, I just want to point out, I'm not going to be really going into the tropical here, but you can clearly see that the sun and the moon, they're right here. And I'm going to show you the actual chart, okay, and the breakdown. Here it is. It's the sun and moon in the tropical. They're at the very end, 29 degrees. They're right there at the end. Well, again, if I go back to the map, If tropical was accurate with synchronizing it to astronomy, the sun and moon would have to be over here. This is at the very end of Aries, but you can see the big gap to where the real placement is and to what tropical's telling you. It's over here. It's not over here. Even there's the daytime. It would be over here. Well, it's not, folks. And so, you know, I'm not trying to be a stickler on this. I'm trying to give you, like, I'm 1 + 1 = 2. I want to know the definitive on these things. And so the true map of the stars is sidereal Vedic astrology, not tropical. Okay. Not saying you can't use it because it has its say and its merit in things. Again, I'm a fan of both. I hope you are as well. But the true map of the stars, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be through sidereal Vedic astrology. Okay. So these are the favorable aspects. And then the last thing I'd want to point out to you here is also taking into consideration the house of Aquarius here in the ninth position, which is owned and operated by Jupiter and Sagittarius. You know, and there is Kronos there, Father Time. And Father Time, of course, likes to slow things down. So, like, all I say here with this position, ladies and gentlemen, is, you know, don't expect miracles overnight because there's some kind of massive solar eclipse happening. You know, plant your seeds, take your time, have no expectations tied to them, have fun with this reality. But these are the tools that we can use. Being the magician at this is a time when you go out there and I'm going to be a magician, like consciously being a magician. And I say that because it's in the house of Aquarius, this may be a really good time for all of you to get out there and mingle and make some new friends, maybe even get rid of some old friends, but to make some new friends. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so that's all I got for today for Decoding Shorts on the solar eclipse, 2023, April 20th. That's all I got. My name is Logan for Decode Your Reality. Until next time, we will see you later.